My name is Mohamed El Araby. I am a graduate of Faculty of Science, Computer Science and Statistics Department in 2008. Started working at LIMS Egypt with Mr. Hussein and Mr. Hamdoud. For basic education, we need some directed content that can be directed to students. We shouldn't let them go to the EKB and start searching and because they are still young, but give them the opportunity to find the relevant content directly through a platform. So we introduced the learning management system within the EKB where we can define the content. Now, currently, we started with the LMS which is for grade 10, and we got the ministry books for physics, chemistry, and biology and mathematics for grade 10. We divided these books into lessons. So we have, for example, unit one, lesson one, lesson two, and so on. We have these lessons available within the LMS. And within each lesson, we have additional content from publishers, Encyclopedia Britannica, Inarit Masr, whoever the publishers who have the content can be put in just one place. So students can go to the study guide in the learning management system, click on electricity in lesson one and find the ministry book and find as well the content, additional content that can help him. This content can be video, can be text, can be just images, questions, a variety of different content types. You will find here additional content coming from Design Main Theorica and from Encyclopedia Britannica. And the content is dual interface. I'm opening now the English interface. If I switch to the Arabic interface, the content available will be in Arabic and the content available as well from the publishers will be in Arabic. So this is the platform for the LMS. And differentiating between is the study guide available here on the left-hand side, the study guide and the digital library. If you go to the study guide, it will show me the content for the grade I'm in right now, which is secondary two. If I open, for example, Egypt and Islamic civilization, which is history for secondary two, you can find that this is unit one, Hadara Arabiya wa Zuhur al-Islam. Lesson one is Hadarat Shabi Gazila Arabiya. This is the ministry book itself, cut into parts. You will find the supplementary content provided by publishers helping students understand this lesson only. You can find English, you can find mathematics, you can find history, you can find Arabic. All the content that I need to be doing this week will be shown. If I need to know what I should do next week, it will be shown as well. Everything will be open as per the timetable provided by the ministry for each lesson. Well, each part of the content here, we just don't get it from the publishers and I put it back to the AKB. We have steps before this. Usually when we get the content, it gets approved by Dr. Nawal Shalabi, the head of CCIMD. The publishers create the content, or if they have the content, just give the content to us, upload it to a sandbox. Dr. Nawal and her team goes to this to the sandbox and review the content provided by any of the publishers. And then CCIMD reviews this content, making sure that the content is correct, matches our curriculum, matching our learning outcomes, is put in the correct place, then it goes back to life. So it usually takes maximum 2 days and is fixed and they get back on the sandbox and will be reviewed by CCIMD. We are still working on the books, making sure the books will appear correctly in the study guide, getting more content from publishers to make it sure it's available for the students in a very good way and in an easy way for sure. The reviews from the CCIMD, they don't stop be reviewing everything in the LMS all the time. Teachers will get special access in the menu over here. Playlists is where teachers can get access and create their own content from the available materials they have in the LMS and the AKB. They can themselves curate content from videos and images and whatever they want into these playlists and share it with their students. Ensure that even if a teacher is uploading something, this is being approved, that this is related to the curriculum and approved by the ministry. We have the assignments. Teachers can start doing assignments for their students and monitor their progress. They can give them statistics about which questions are being asked correctly and the most questions that have been answered incorrectly. So the teachers don't know where are the gaps in what they have taught to their students. Teachers together can have their own networks. They can start working together. And in the classes, it's direct learning between the class, between the teacher and his students. He can have discussions, he can share files, he can do whatever he wants with the classes, can share assignments, monitor their progress, and work with the students. And event be created for the ministry or for the school itself, it can be done over here. This the right part over here is totally managed by teachers. It's training and proper development to make sure that they can use the platform in the best way. And it's not overwhelming because introducing the digital learning and going, making them go to the internet and start working through the content available on the internet is a challenge itself. So we do the training for them, and they go, by the way, and train teachers in the schools. It's nice, but we are still working to make it better. So it never stops.